Hello YouTube, welcome to Answering ATPL. In today's video, we will discuss on the subject of general navigation under the topic basic of navigation, subtopic the earth, under the title great circle, small circle, rhumb line, convergency and conversion angle. Scope of the video will cover small circle, rhumb line, great circle, convergency and conversion angle. The first concept that we need to understand is small circle. By definition, small circle is a circle on the surface of a sphere whose plane does not pass through the sphere's center. To better understand the definition, let me illustrate it for you. This is a sphere. The intersection between the two green lines is the sphere center. Here is a circle drawn on the surface of the sphere. Shaded in red is the plane of the circle. As you can see from the diagram, the plane of the circle does not cut through the center of the sphere, thus qualifying this circle as a small circle. The second fact that you need to remember about small circle: all parallel of latitude is a small circle except equator. The second concept that we need to understand is rhumb line. Definition: rhumb line is a line on the earth's surface cutting all meridian at the same angle. A fact that you need to remember about rhumb line: when you fly a rhumb line track, you are not flying a great circle track except when flying along equator and meridian. Meridian is another name for longitude. To better understand the concept of rhumb line, here is an illustration. The green sphere represents the earth, an aircraft, and a red arrow. The red arrow represents a compass that always points to true north. If the aircraft travels from east to west along 60 degree north latitude, as you can see, the relative angle between the red arrow and nose of the aircraft does not change. In other words, we can say that the angle is constant. In this scene, we will look at the same situation as before, but we replace the aircraft and the red arrow with a compass card. If the compass card travel from east to west along the parallel of latitude, the heading will be constant. Thus, we can deduce when traveling on rhumb line, track is constant. This picture was taken from Google Earth. If you want to fly from A to B and maintain a constant track, you will actually fly a curved track representing by the red dotted line. A rhumb line track is actually a spiral track that originates from north and south pole unless it is on heading of 360, 090, 180 and 270. In other words, it is on a cardinal heading. The second concept that we need to understand is the great circle. By definition, great circle is a line on the surface of the earth where the center coincides with the center of the earth. The shortest distance between two positions on the surface of the earth is connected via a great circle. When flying on great circle, track is constantly changing. These are the three facts that you need to remember about great circle. Let's say we want to travel from A to B via the shortest distance. As per discussed on the previous slide, the shortest distance between A and B is via a great circle that is represented by the dotted line. As we already know, When traveling along a great circle track, the heading will constantly change. Here is an illustration with an aircraft and a red arrow that always point toward true north. As you can see, when the aircraft travel along the great circle, the angle between the red arrow and the nose of the aircraft is constantly changing. This confirms the fact that when traveling along a great circle track, the heading or track is constantly changing. In this scene, I replaced the aircraft and the red arrow with a compass card. Here, we want to know what will happen to our true track when traveling from east to west. We start at approximately 290 track. And we end up at approximately 250. Thus, when moving west in northern hemisphere, track decrease. In this scene, we will investigate what will happen to our track when we travel from west to east. We start at approximately 070. And we end up at approximately 110. We can conclude that when moving east in northern hemisphere, track increase. From what we have learned, it all can be summarized into this one simple diagram. This line represents the equator. And this line represents the prime meridian. To the right of the prime meridian is east, and to the left, west. Above the equator is northern hemisphere, and below the equator is southern hemisphere. By looking at this diagram, if you travel west in the northern hemisphere, your track will decrease. D represents decrease. If you travel east in the northern hemisphere, your track will increase. I stands for increase. If you travel to the west in the southern hemisphere, your track will increase. And if you travel to the east in the southern hemisphere, your track will decrease. That is how we use this diagram. Let's look back to our previous example. If you want to fly from A to B maintaining the constant heading, you will fly on a rhumb line track represented by the red dotted line. But if you want to fly the closest distance between A and B, you need to fly on a great circle track represented by the blue line. The fourth concept that we need to understand is convergency. This is a sphere representing the Earth. This line represents latitude, and this line represents meridian, also known as longitude. If we bring this meridian from here to here, it will create an angle here. The angle here is known as convergency. Convergence can also be defined as the angular difference between the measurement of a great circle at each meridian. What does it mean? Look at the diagram. On the right hand side is where the track begins, and on the left hand side is where the track ends. If you look at the compass card, both headings are different. If we take the first heading, approximately 290, and minus it with the second heading, approximately 250, the answer will be convergence. Before I forget, convergence and convergency is the same thing. Do not get confused. There are four types of convergence in general navigation subject. The first one is the Earth convergence. Formula is convergence equal to change in longitude times sine mean latitude. Second type of convergence is the chart convergence. Chart convergence can be divided into three. First one is polar stereographic. Convergent equal to change in longitude. The second one, Lambert. Convergent equal to change in longitude time sine parallel of origin. And the last one is make it convergent equal to zero. The last concept that we need to understand is the conversion angle. Conversion angle is an angle between grid circle track and rhumb line track. In this scene, I will try to explain how to use this diagram in order to solve the grid circle track problem. If you were given position A and position B, you need to travel from position A to position B. As you can see, A on the west side and B on the east side. And we assume that we are in the northern hemisphere. If we transfer the data given into this diagram, here's northern hemisphere. A should be here and B should be here. A lie in sector D, which means decrease, and B lie in sector I, which means increase. What we can deduce is true track at A is less than true track at B. The other thing that we can deduce is true track at A equal to rhumb line track minus conversion angle, and true track at B equal to rhumb line track plus conversion angle. This is the usage of this diagram. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to leave your comment if there is anything you would like me to clarify. Thank you. Have a nice day. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and check out other videos.